Turning now to KCRA 3 weather, and just a gorgeous day out there. Of course, a lot of people getting ready for the total solar eclipse. So, Dirk, what can people expect weather-wise for the viewing tomorrow?
I think a lot of folks are going to be jealous of our weather because we're going to have the clear conditions. We're looking pretty good here in California for the partial eclipse, but where the total eclipse is going on, the path of totality, there's a lot of cloud cover. In fact, if you know anybody that's been traveling or we're going to be traveling to Texas to see this, there's a lot of cloud cover as it makes its way from Eagle Pass towards San Antonio and Austin. It's going to be moving. The shadow's moving very quickly, about 1,600 miles per hour as it makes its way across Texas. But you can see we have cloud cover and even rain in the forecast in some of these areas of totality. Dallas-Fort Worth area, also lots of cloud cover. So again, not the best viewing. As we cut across Arkansas, it looks like the cloud cover may be broken up a bit, so there's a better chance for getting a good view. The shadow at this point is picking up speed. It's at 1,700 miles per hour as it races across Arkansas and heads past Kentucky and on into Indiana, where I know some people have gone to the Indianapolis Speedway to watch this event. There may be some cloud cover, but I think you have a pretty good chance of seeing it a little bit better because I think there'll be some breaks, but it's going to be moving. That shadow at 2,000 miles per hour. Cleveland, looks like there may be some clouds to contend with in Cleveland. Buffalo, looks like there may be some breaks in the cloud cover, but there's also a chance for rain, as you can see from Toronto towards Buffalo. And then really the better spot in totality to watch this is going to be Maine. Who would have thought that? Travel to Maine to see the clearest skies and watch totality as that shadow moves across the state of Maine at 3,000 miles per hour.